Now, we have discussed about the mechanisms of elimination reaction as well as the nucleophilic substitution reaction. Let us do first of all some of the examples. After this, we will do the comparison between elimination reaction and a substitution reaction. That we call it as a elimination versus substitution, which actually will help you people to decide that the conditions given to us are favorable for elimination reaction or are favorable for substitution reaction. Now, let us discuss some of the examples of elimination reaction. Now, elimination reaction, as I have told you in the layout of the reaction mechanism, that this reaction is shown by haloalkanes, that is RX, as well as by alcohols, that is ROH. The reaction which is being shown by alcohols is known as dehydration of alcohols, whereas the reaction shown by RX, that is haloalkanes, is known as dehydrohalogenation of haloalkanes. As the name suggests, dehydrohalogenation, D means removal, hydro means hydrogen, halogen means X, that is, that could be Cl, Br or I. We will discuss this first of all with respect to the dehydration of alcohols. Now, in the dehydration of alcohol, first of all, we will be having a OH group. Now, OH group in the dehydration of alcohols is not a good leaving group. So, our first job is to make this OH as a good leaving group so that we can have an elimination mechanism. Now, for that matter, what we do is, first of all, protonation, that is addition of a proton to the compound. So, what we do is, in a dehydration of alcohols, it is always in the first step, what happens is we add acid. Now, that acid H plus will always come from H2SO4 or from H3PO4, which is known as phosphoric acid, and H2SO4 is known as sulfuric acid. But you people might have a question, there are other acids, as in we have HCl, we have HNO3 also. Why can't we use these reagents for the protonation in the dehydration of alcohols? I will tell you after this, after an example. Let us do one example for the alcohols, that is the dehydration of alcohols, and which will be illustrating us, will help us to know that how a alcohol given to us is showing a elimination reaction. Now, briefly, first of all, what happens? A protonation takes place, that is H plus from the acid, which would be either H2SO4 or it will be HCl. Then after the protonation, what happens is alcohol forms OH2 plus group. Now this H2O plus, or we say OH2 plus group, is a very good leaving group. Once the leaving group is formed, then the elimination reaction starts. Again, the question comes, alcohol given to us will undergo E1 mechanism or will undergo E2 mechanism. As we can see clearly in the mechanism of E1, that a carbocation formation is there. That means a 3-degree alcohol will form a 3-degree carbocation. Similarly, a 2-degree alcohol will form a 2-degree carbocation, and a 1-degree alcohol will form a 1-degree carbocation. Now, we can clearly now say that 3-degree alcohol will undergo E1 reaction fastest, then a 2-degree alcohol will undergo bit at a slower rate than a 3-degree alcohol, whereas the 1-degree alcohol will undergo the slowest. Reason I have already told you just now is based on the stability of the carbocations. But there is slight difference in the E2 mechanism. Like in SN2, we said that it is, the order is 1-degree compound, then a 2-degree compound, then a 3-degree compound. But a difference in elimination 2 reaction is, 3 degree compound will undergo the fastest, then a 2 degree compound, then a 1 degree compound. Why is it so? The reason is, first reason, that in the elimination reaction, base does not attack on the carbon which has got a leaving group. Therefore, there is no point of steric hindrance. Steric hindrance is nothing, it is the repulsive force between the bulky groups. Next, 3 degree alcohol will undergo fastest in E2 mechanism. Why is it so? Because a 3 degree alcohol will form a stable alkene. That is on the basis of number of hyperconjugative structures, which we have already seen in the general organic chemistry, that is GOC. That is why in the E2 mechanism also we have the order 3 degree, 2 degree and then 1 degree. But again you might have a question in your mind that E1 is also showing 3 degree, 2 degree, 1 degree. E2 is also showing 3 degree, 2 degree, 1 degree. How will you decide that a particular reactant given to you will undergo E1 mechanism or E2 mechanism?